1, 2, 3, 4. On the road again. Just can't wait to get on the road again.
Well, I've been a little slow on videos lately. I've been trying to take care of this crazy wrist of mine. Tendonitis in there. Really painful, so I had to give it a little bit of rest. And glad to report that I'm probably up to about 75% healed now. The rest really helped. Something I should have been doing all along, but of course I didn't do. I just kept abusing it, and then it kept just flaring up on me. So some of that time I moved a lot of tools around, took some clamps down to make room for other items, and now I've got more clamps to put up, so I'll have to do a little more restructuring. But I wanted to get my latest items up on the wall, which I have, my drills and other items that I've done recently. And so did take up a little of my time, but I did take time to restore the two clamps I've got today. But I'm slowing down a little bit, trying to get everything healed. But damn, that wall's looking good, if I must say so myself. Here's a very interesting clamp I found. Hallwell Tool Company, Los Angeles, California. Before I bought this, I did a lot of research. It really caught my eye, but I'd never seen one before. And could not find any information on the company, Hallwell. The clamp, I didn't find any trace of it, at least on the internet, everywhere I looked, in all types of records and patents. Couldn't find anything about it, even though it says patent pending. But there were two others on eBay besides this one, both of them being $70. One of them was $70 plus a $27 shipping, which is really high. Taking it close to $100. That's out of my league, especially for a clamp like this. But this one was $35, starting bid. So I said, you know, gonna roll the dice and go for it. I just like it. I'll see what I got. I don't know whether it's worth anything or not, but it's unusual. It'll be a nice item in the collection. Here's how it works. And of course, you clamp it onto the work like that, and then you tighten it further here. And once you tighten it, it's rock solid. It's a really tight grip on there. Also, you notice here how much take up it's got, how much further you can turn this. If you keep turning this knob and this additional travel you got on it, you've got quite a bit there, about maybe 5/8 to 3/4 inch additional grip. The clamp itself, I got my trusty magnet out. It's either got to be aluminum, this end, let's see here, aluminum, or it's a non-ferrous metal of some type, because it's not magnetic. Probably aluminum, I would think. A non-ferrous metal probably wouldn't be very strong, not like the aluminum would be. And but it is unusual. I'm going to clean it up, and I'm sure it'll look very nice. And in the meantime, I'll keep looking for information on this item. Okay, just part of the way through wire brushing, I was looking it over, and here's something we're going to have to spend some time on. It's not going to be just wire brushing. We're going to have to do some sanding. Really rough casting all the way around here. Needs to be addressed. Line goes all the way around. It's also on the inside here. And once we get that smoothed out and this all polished up, it's going to be a really nice looking clamp. Then I'm going to have to decide, do I want to just finish it out in a natural finish or put some paint on it. So that'll be a decision for later. Still got a lot of wire brushing and sanding to do on here to get it in shape for a final finish. Well, here's the hot weld clamp after wire brushing. As you can see, that aluminum shined up really nice. We're going to have to take and put this on the belt sander and get this casting marks off. And then, I don't know, I like the color, but then again, it's just sort of plain. I've got a lot of nice paint, and I've got what I think might be the perfect color, kind of a sage green, lighter green. I'm going to try on here and see what we do. Like I said, when you paint and it doesn't work, that's why you have paint stripper. You can take it off and do something else, but I'll see what it looks like with some paint on it, and then see if it looks any better than this and decide what to do. With all the many clamps I have, I never had a pony clamp before, so I found one at a super price, and I bought it. It's just a deep throat clamp, actually Pony brand, says so on here. Pony, model number 245. It's a heavy duty clamp, you can see with the bolsters in the corners. It's got some issues, it's old and rusty. It's not too banged up and beat up, but you can see here there's a bit of an issue. I think this screw is somewhat crooked, and of course that'll have to be tightened. It's rusty, working kind of tight, and well, it's actually as it moves, it binds, but that's because of the bend in it. So we'll have to get that straightened out and fixed and cleaned up and painted a right nice red color, probably since the original was red. So there we go, we'll fix it up. Remember what this hot weld clamp looked like when I got it? Dirty and discolored, and I pretty much determined it is aluminum. It wasn't a pot metal or a die cast metal of any kind. It was actually aluminum. So it was pretty lightweight, and it was just, like I say, dark and discolored. And you saw when I cleaned it up, I decided to go ahead and paint it though. And here's what it looked like. Painted and restored, all the metal on it polished. Looks really nice, and of course the edges had casting marks on them. They were completely smoothed out. And I decided to go ahead and put the nice green color on it, and turned into a nice item. The quick acting clamp, hot weld clamp. Haven't seen this anywhere before. I've looked and looked, other than two I saw for sale on eBay that were $70 each, plus one of them another 27 shipping, almost 100. Ended up paying 35 for mine with shipping, so I think I got a pretty good deal. It was more than I'd paid for clamps, but it was so unusual. I couldn't find any history on the company or anything else about it, so I thought it'd be a good item to have in the collection, and just turned out just beautiful. Happy to have it. The other clamp I worked on was this nice pony clamp. First pony clamp I've had in my collection, and it was really dark and discolored on the other side. Had a huge weld. Wasn't even like a splatter, it was welded on there, a big piece, and you could see on this side of it, it was just darkened, so it was evidently a lot of heat applied, so opposite this stain here was the big weld splatter. So we ground that off, cleaned it up, straightened up the best we could on the screw, and these parts, this clamp was actually really hard steel. Took a lot of work to file down the castings and the bang marks on it, and the banging that had been done to it over the years. Just filing was tough. I've seen that before on other clamps. Evidently, it's a pretty high strength steel or just a really heavy heat treat. Very hard to work on, but the sanding belt was the key thing. Used that pretty extensively to clean it up. And here's the clamp all cleaned up. I was going to go with a red color, but I just like this orange, this red-orange color I have. I decided to use it, and I think it turned out nice on here. Sides are all smooth now. The casting marks cleaned up nicely on here. All the edges, which were chattered pretty bad, are cleaned up. And the screw itself straightened up. This pin straightened up as best I could. I may have to get a new pin for here. I tried and tried, did a lot of straightening on it and couldn't get it completely straight. It's as straight as I could get it. But for now, heck of an improvement with the hardware shined, and that nice orange color just seemed to be perfect for this pony clamp. Don't know why I never had one before, but I've got it now, and great addition to the collection. And here's the two restorations for the day. Beautiful little items. Glad to have them. I hope you enjoyed my restoration video.